Well, good morning and welcome to SaskTel Center in Saskatoon for the 84th anniversary of Saskatoon's Remembrance Day service. So my name is David Curtin. This is the 84th anniversary, but there are a number of anniversaries that will be recognized and celebrated here today during this Remembrance Day ceremony. And we welcome all viewers in Saskatoon and Prince Albert to our broadcast today. Today, the theme is the 90th anniversary of the Royal Canadian Legion. But we will also be celebrating, as I said, a few other anniversaries as well. The 175th anniversary of the Army, Navy, Air Force veterans in Canada, maybe better known as the Anavets. And the 70th anniversary of the liberation of the Netherlands. And so those anniversaries will be recognized throughout the service here today at the SaskTel Center. The big theme, however, is going to definitely be the anniversary, the 90th anniversary of the Royal Canadian Legion, which was established in Canada in November of 1925. And I should mention that branch number 63, which is on the west side of Saskatoon, used to be located on 19th Street in Saskatoon, now located closer to the river on 17th Street. The branch number 63 was formed just a year later in October of 1926. And the Royal Canadian Legion isn't only for military veterans. Its membership includes people who have served in the military, but also in the Royal Canadian Mounted Police, provincial municipal police forces, and of course the Royal Canadian Air, Army, and Sea Cadets, and they all direct relatives to those veterans as well. The service here today is being coordinated for the first time ever by Saskatoon's 38th Field Battalion. Every year it switches over from Army to Navy to the Air Force to coordinate the service. This year it is the Army, but in previous years when the Army has coordinated the service, it has always been the North Saskatchewan Regiment that has coordinated the service. So for the first time of this year, it is the 38th Field Battalion, and the first representative of the 38th Field Battalion will be Master Warrant Officer Shelley Belisle, and she'll be calling for the markers in about 10 minutes' time. You are hearing in the background right now some of the music that is being given to the people here at SaskTel Center. Always a great big turnout from our various musical organizations, including the Salvation Army Band, directed by Peter England, with guests from the Bridge City Brass Band, the Saskatoon Brass Band, the Saskatoon Community Wind Ensemble, the Saskatoon Men's Chorus, and of course, later on, we are going to hear more music during the parade on to the field from North Saskatchewan Regiment Pipes and Drums, Jarvis Bay Sea Cadet Band, Saskatoon Shrine Band, the Medical First Response will be here as well. So the music right now is being supplied by the three major bands in Saskatoon: Salvation Army Band, Bridge City Brass Band, the Saskatoon Community Wind Ensemble, and of course the Saskatoon Brass Band. Let's just listen to that for a moment. So as I said, the theme today, the 90th anniversary of the Royal Canadian Legion. I talked about the Saskatoon branch number 63. There are various branches in Saskatoon, including the Tuberculosis Veterans Branch, which has been around since before World War II. the Dr. Harold Anderson Memorial Branch, number 78, and of course the Nutana Branch, number 362. And they will all, representatives of these various branches of the Royal Canadian Legion, will be receiving the salute today when the parade marches off. And those who are going to be representing the Royal Canadian Legion today, Shirley Ashton, who is the first vice president, Marguerite Wolfe and Rose Ferguson will also be there to accept the honors. Today, we have the honor of our Lieutenant Governor, Yvonne Solomon Schofield, who will be here for the ceremony today. And she will be paraded on in a special moment during the service. As I said, this is the 175th anniversary of the Anne of Vets, the Army, Navy, and Air Force Veterans of Canada, Canada's oldest veterans association. They say that the precise date of its start has been basically obscured by time, but it is known that a charter was given by Queen Victoria back in 1840 to create a unit in Montreal. But it is felt that the Anne of Vets existed well before that time, but that is the charter time, and that is what we're recognizing today. But if you go back before 1840, following the War of 1812, sailors from the British Navy, which patrolled the Great Lakes and the Eastern Seaboard, who remained in Canada, they joined the Army Veterans in Canada, an organization. Then the title was then changed to the Army and Navy Veterans in Canada. And the association was also composed of volunteers who answered the call of the Canadian government for active service during the Fenian Raids of 1860, 1870, 1871, the Red River Expedition of 1870, and, as we all know, the Northwest Rebellion of 1885. So that's a bit of a history on the Anne of Vets as we celebrate the 175th anniversary of the Anne of Vets. There is going to be a moment during, before the service begins today, in which we will hear a bit of a small tribute to a man who has had a lot to do with the coordination and organization of the various Saskatoon Remembrance Day services, Don McDonald, who was the piper of the North Saskatchewan Regiment Pipes and Drums for so many years. And we will see a little bit of a recognition for Don McDonald just before the actual services to begin. The Reverend Colin Clay will be the one who will conduct the service today once the service is turned over to him. Reverend Colin Clay, for many, many years, had been a chaplain at the University of Saskatchewan, an Anglican minister, but he is also himself a Korean War veteran. And so he will be leading the service once it is turned over to him. We see now the Cenotaph Guard is being paraded on, and the Cenotaph Guard this year is being led by Sergeant Mike Wong, who was born in Saskatoon in 2003. Sergeant Wong joined the infantry as part of the North Saskatchewan Regiment. He's been deployed to Afghanistan in 2009 and 2010. Also a part of the Arctic Response Company Group, which conducts training in the Arctic Circle on a yearly basis. Also on that Cenotaph Guard is a Private Shannon Young, originally from Halifax, Nova Scotia. Works at the detachment Dundurn as a construction technician. And prior to joining the military in 2014, she traveled to 17 different countries, studied heritage carpentry at the Nova Scotia Community College. The only female in her program, she graduated at the top of the class. Also on the Cenotaph Guard, Master Seaman Megan Lloyd, representing the Navy, born in Yorkton, Saskatchewan, joined the Royal Canadian Navy in 2007 at HMCS Queen as a resource management support clerk and transferred to HMCS Unicorn in 2009. This is Master Seaman Lloyd's first year as a Cenotaph Guard representative. Constable Elizabeth Cook is with the Saskatoon RCMP and currently posted to Whitecap Dakota First Nation. She's been with the RCMP for 8 years. All of Constable Cook's career has been in the province of Saskatchewan. And Constable Cook is a band member of the Lac La Ronge Indian Band, born and raised in the Stanley Mission. And Master Corporal Trevor Christofferson. He grew up in the small town of Quill Lake and moved to Saskatoon after high school and joined the Army Reserves in 2008, now serving as a weapons technician with the 38th Service Battalion.
Shoulder up. Present up. Rest on your arms, reverse.
You see now Master Warrant Officer Shelley Belisle of the 38th Field Battalion. She's calling for the markers.
Master Warrant Officer Shelley Belisle has just called for the markers. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to pay tribute to a man who has given many, many years of his time, not only as the Master Piper of the North Saskatchewan Regiment, is now retired, but has also guided this service for many years to where and what has become today. Ladies and gentlemen, you will note off to our right, at the end of the dignitary robes and the blue chairs, a man that is standing with the assistance of his walker. Ladies and gentlemen, Don McDonald.
Don McDonald has been such an integral part of the Saskatoon Remembrance Day ceremonies for so many years. And today he is here as an observer. Once the markers are in place, the VIPs will be brought to their seats.
Number one, stand fast. Remainder, aim out! Turn!
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would ask our VIPs to take their seats.
The VIPs who will be coming in today representing the Government of Canada, the newly elected a Member of Parliament, Kevin Wong, and representing the Government of Saskatchewan is Roger Perrott, and of course, Saskatoon's Mayor, Don Acheson. And as the VIPs are being let in, Master Warrant Officer Shelley Belisle has called for the cadets and service groups to be marched on. And they're going to be led by the Saskatoon Shrine Drum and Bugle Band. Here they come.
Saskatoon Shrine Drum and Bugle Band. Seven Spitfire Royal Canadian Air Cadets.
Number
on your screen right now, a 107 Spitfire, Royal Canadian Air Cadets. These are what they call
702 Lynx Wing Royal Canadian Air Cadet Squadron.
Right behind 107 Spitfire Royal Canadian Air Cadets, the 702 Lynx Royal Canadian Air Cadet Squadron. And you can see the Saskatoon and District Freemasons now parading out on the platform along with the Saskatoon Shriners are right behind them.
And Knights of the Lovers.
And following the last group coming in for the first row are the Knights of Columbus. Spitfire Royal Canadian Air Cadets, the 702 Lynx Royal Canadian Air Cadet Squadron, Saskatoon and District Freemasons, Shriners, Knights of Columbus are in place. We're getting ready for our second row to parade on. Sea Cadets.
Number 45, Jarvis Bay,
the Jarvis Bay Royal Canadian Sea Cadet Corps. Always good to see such good membership in these cadet groups.
Followed by number 2293, Royal Canadian Army Cadet Corps. Number 328, Royal Canadian Army Medical Cadet Corps. And the Junior Canadian Rangers.
Well, the parade has taken a bit of a different route this year as they have had to squeeze through various groups. Interesting, and they did it very well. Now, the third row coming on, led by the RCMP.
Begins with the Royal Canadian Mounted Police.
Following the Royal Canadian Mounted Police in their red serge, the Federal Correctional Services. Then the Provincial Correctional Services right behind. And then you'll hear a great round of applause. The Saskatoon Police Service is coming onto the platform along with the Saskatoon Fire Department.
The ambulance following
behind. So when the cadets, service groups, and the police units are all in position, which won't take very long, a master warrant to Officer Shelley Belisle will be calling for the marching on of the new guard.
Getting ready for position, Master Warrant Officer Bell.
New Guard.
Going to hear the sounds now of the Jarvis Bay Sea Cadet Band. They will be the ones leading on the New Guard.
March on the New Guard!
New Guard, of course, currently serving Canadian Forces units, which have taken over from the old guard, defensive cabinet. And of course, it consists of, here in Saskatoon, HMCS Unicorn. And they have led the way, followed by the North Saskatchewan Regiment. And now we have members in the audience beginning to stand as the New Guard comes in. The North Saskatchewan Regiment is followed by a 38th Service Battalion, joined by the 16th Field Ambulance.
And the 38th Combat Engineering Unit.
Our veterans are currently serving in Canadian military units. So now that the New Guard is on and the service organizations, the Cadet Corps, are all on the platform now, Master Warrant Officer Shelley Belisle is going to turn the parade over to the Deputy Parade Commander, Captain Ian Parker. And on marches Captain Ian Parker. It is Captain Ian Parker's job to fall in the officers now.
Remembrance Day Parade, New Guard, stand at ease. Attention. Officers, fall in.
And over to our right, we see the officers for the various regiments, the battalions, now marching on. And as the officers fall in, Captain Parker will turn the parade over to the parade commander, Lieutenant Colonel Gwen Bork of 38th Service Battalion. we now see a Lieutenant Colonel Gwen Bourque marching out.
Parade Commander Lieutenant Colonel Gwen Bourque of the 38th Service Battalion is now taking her position, and Captain Parker will be turning the parade over to her.
You will hear the two words from Lieutenant Colonel Gwen Bourque, "Old Guard." Saskatchewan Regiment Pipes and Drums leads on with the Old Guard.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Old Guard.
So our veterans from the various wars and missions now that the parade will be dressed momentarily, and then Lieutenant Colonel Bourque will be calling for the colors to be marched on. Process of dressing the parade. In a moment, we will see the precision of a parade when Lieutenant Colonel Bourque calls for the colors to be marched on.
Lieutenant Colonel Bourque is called for the colors to be marched.
colors coming in under the command of Second Lieutenant Denny King.
Parade to the flag, salute.
The colors are being marched on under the command of Second Lieutenant Denny King.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please remain standing for the entrance and arrival of Her Honor, the Lieutenant Governor of Saskatchewan, Vaughn Sullivan Schofield, to be piped in by Brad Fenty.
Pray attention. Pray, Vice Regal salute.
Piper Brad Fenty, who is piping in Lieutenant Governor Vaughn Sullivan Schofield. We asked Piper Brad Fenty earlier today who he was wishes to be representing. He, of course, is a piper with the North Saskatchewan Regiment. But because of the 90th anniversary of the Royal Canadian Legions, you see that that is what he is wearing as his regalia today, representing the
Pray
Royal Canadian
attention.
Legion.
Please remain standing for the Vice Regal salute.
Parade Commander will now turn the parade over to Reverend Colin Clay.
Now turn the parade over to Reverend Colin Clay.
Thank you. My name is Colin Clay, and it is my honor and privilege to welcome you all, our Lieutenant Governor, our veterans, all service personnel, our cadets, and those who keep us safe, the police services and firefighters, and our musicians here today, and of course, every one of you who's come here to share in this service, in which we honor those who served and those who died in order that we in Canada might live in freedom. We give thanks that in our country we value that freedom and peace which we enjoy. But as we know, we live in a deeply troubled world, and so on this day, we pray for peace among all nations and all people. Now, I invite you, those who are able, to stand, and as we join in the singing of our hymn, God of our fathers, known of old. I invite you to be seated. It is now my privilege to help us recognize all veterans present here today with their families and all serving personnel. If you're able, would you please stand, or if that's not possible, kindly raise your hand so that you may be recognized and we will all.
Many, many veterans who are in the stands, not necessarily on the parade, being recognized right now. It's a hearty round of applause from the crowd here at Saskatoon Center.
Thank you so much. I now invite Padre Ivan Nahachowski to lead us in the psalm.
Captain Ivan Nahachowski is the chaplain with the North Saskatchewan Regiment.
Psalm 121. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, O whence cometh my help? My help cometh even from the Lord, who hath made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved, and he that keepeth thee will not sleep. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself is thy keeper. The Lord is thy defense upon thy right hand, so that the sun shall not burn thee by day, neither the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. Yea, it is even he that shall keep thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in, from this time forth forevermore.
Thank you. I now invite Ms. Tanis Shostobitov to sing for us, Let There Be Peace on Earth, and Let It Begin With Me.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be.
Thank you so much. In a few moments, we shall share in the act of remembrance, and we shall all stand when we come to that point when you hear the chimes. As we hear the trumpet call, we shall observe the silence in which we remember those who gave their lives so that we might live in freedom and peace. We remember those who fell in two world wars, in Korea, as peacekeepers in many regions of the world, and those more recently in Afghanistan. I invite you to stand as we wait for the chimes to remind us of 11 o'clock. shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them. Would you be seated, please? Before we continue with our prayers, and the chaplains are ready for the prayers, I would like to mention, and you may hear this again today, that for a number of years, the program coordinator for this Saskatoon Remembrance Day service has been Don McDonald, a well-known retired piper in this community. Don is present with us once again today, and we have the opportunity to pay tribute to Don and to say thank you, Don, for your long and dedicated service. Now welcome to the podium Padre Nancy Bootinger, who is the Padre of HMCS Unicorn.
By our presence here today, we show our commitment to our veterans and to their families. So to remember their service and sacrifice for our country, be that the sacrifice of their lives, or perhaps the sacrifice that's carried by the living, permanently marked by war. We remember all of our veterans in thanksgiving and in prayer. As we enter into this time of prayer, I'd like to invite you to take that time as you need. Maybe it's silent reflection, but do that which fulfills your beliefs. Let us pray. Creator God, we gather today to remember those who by air, sea, or land lost their lives in times of war. We remember those from Canada, from our allies, and those from many other nations who sacrificed their lives, so that those of future generations might live in peace and harmony. We also remember those who returned and recognize their sorrow, their anguish of body, mind, and spirit as they live with physical, mental, and spiritual wounds. We ask you that you might bring them healing and care for what they might need. And we ask you for your help as we try and attempt to walk with those. We ask for a blessing upon our Queen Elizabeth and for those that govern, that they may do so with wisdom, equity, justice, compassion. Bless our elected leaders at every level of government in Canada, working for us so that we may live in peace amongst our neighbors. Amen.
Thank you so much, Padre Nancy. And now I welcome to the podium the Padre of the North Saskatchewan Regiment, the Reverend Captain Ivan Nahachowski.
In solidarity with chaplains everywhere, past, present, and future, let us pray. We pray for peace and understanding in the world. We pray for those who serve justice and those who promote mutual respect. In particular, we pray for the men and the women of the Canadian Armed Forces as they stand on guard for us. Lord, enhance their personal well-being. Make them physically strong and healthy. Give them social maturity, emotional balance, and spiritual resilience. Help them to be the best they can be in order to preserve peace. Turn all of us into peacemakers, especially enlighten the youth of the world, so that they might discover new paths of harmony between cultures and ideologies. Bless every race and tongue and creed, that we might all embrace the one common unity that often eludes us. For all things are possible with you, Lord and God, for you are holy now and forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you so much. And I now welcome to the podium Rabbi Claudio Jodorkovsky, who is the rabbi at Agudas Israel Synagogue in Saskatoon.
El Malei Rachamim, God who is full of mercy. We pray today for the suffering, the hungry, the refugee, the prisoner, the slave, the persecuted. May we hold lovingly in our thoughts all those who suffer from tyranny, subjection, cruelty, indifference, and injustice, and may we work every day towards the alleviation of their suffering. Help us, God, to recognize our solidarity with the stranger, outcast, abused, and deprived, that no human being be treated as other, that our common humanity weaves us together in one fabric of mutuality, one garment of destiny. May we pursue the biblical prophet's vision of peace, that we might live harmoniously with each other side by side, respecting differences, cherishing diversity, with no one exploiting the weak, each living without fear of the other, each revering divinity in every human soul. Teach us to struggle against institutional injustice, to free those from oppression and contempt, to act with purity of heart and mind, despising none, defrauding none, hating none, cherishing all, honoring every child of God, every creature of the earth. In this day of remembrance, we pay tribute to the victims of the Nazi Holocaust during the Second World War, together with the victims of all genocides and persecutions. We ask you, compassionate God, who are the source of mercy, to shelter them beneath your wings eternally and bind their souls among the living that they may rest in peace. They gave their lives that we might be free from human evil, with hope for the future of all people. May the memory of their sacrifice inspire us to battle against human suffering. May their souls be bound up in the bonds of eternal life, for God is with them. May they rest in eternal peace, and let us say, Amen.
Thank you so much. In a few moments, we shall begin the laying of the wreaths. I'd just like to explain a little bit of what we've done here this morning at the Act of Remembrance. The trumpet call, we know as the last post, was traditionally sounded each night throughout the tents of the soldiers beside the battlefield. All prayed for a silent rest before the trumpet sounded reveille to waken them in the morning. Today, the last post and the piper's lament that follows reminds us of those we knew and loved and who are now at rest. And we continued with the silence, and then we heard the trumpet call, the reveille, the awakening. For the departed, a new and abundant life. And to the rest of us, the call to strive for a world of peace in our hearts and around our world. We will now have the laying of the wreaths.
We, as we get ready for the laying of the wreaths, I can tell you that the estimate of the attendance here at Sastel Center has reached a new record high. The estimate sits at 9,640, very close to 10,000 here today at Sastel Center. So basically, a new record for what is already the largest indoor Remembrance Day ceremony in Canada.
Naismith died May 26, 2003, during an exercise flying the Maple Leaf. Laying a wreath on behalf of the Government of Canada, the Honorable Kevin Waugh. Laying a wreath on behalf of the Province of Saskatchewan, MLA Roger Parent. Our next wreath layer, the Honorable Brad Trost, Member of Parliament. laying a wreath on behalf of Veterans Affairs Canada, Annette Jayeb. Laying a wreath on behalf of the citizens of Saskatoon, His Worship Mayor Don Acheson. Laying a wreath on behalf of the Rural Municipality of Corman Park, Reeve Judy Harwood. Laying a wreath on behalf of the Remembrance Committee, Brent Wignis. Wreaths are also being laid by the Saskatchewan Provincial Command, the Royal Canadian Legion, and Colin Paul. National Command, TVS Veterans, Royal Canadian Legion, Clarence Paul. Provincial Command, Army, Navy, and Air Force Veterans in Canada, Alf Christensen. Saskatoon Branch Number 63, Royal Canadian Legion, and Shirley Aston. Harold Anderson Memorial Branch Number 78, Royal Canadian Legion, Marguerite Wolfe. Batana Branch Number 362, Royal Canadian Legion, Rose Ferguson. Saskatoon Unit Number 38, Army, Navy, and Air Force Veterans, Jim Eaton. Embassy of Belgium in Ottawa, Paul Van Plue. Maple Leaf Unit Number 287, Army, Navy, and Air Force Veterans. Ladies Auxiliary to the Saskatoon Unit Number 38, Army, Navy, and Air Force Veterans. RCAF Number 602, Link Squadron Association. Korea Veterans Association. United Nations Peacekeepers. The Last Post Fund. Royal Regina Rifles Association. HMCS Unicorn Ships Company. Seventeen Winged Attachment Dunder. North Saskatchewan Regiment. North Saskatchewan Regiment Association. 38 Service Battalion, Saskatoon Detachment. .38 Combat Engineers Regiment. Commissionaires, North Saskatchewan Division. Royal Canadian Mounted Police, Saskatoon District. RCMP Veterans Association. Saskatoon City Police Service, Chief Clive Wayhill. Saskatoon City Police Association. Saskatoon Fire Department, Deputy Fire Chief. Saskatoon Fire Department, Local Number 80. Correctional Services of Canada. Union of Canadian Correctional Officers. Canadian Borders Service Agency. Saskatoon Paramedic Association, IAFF, Local 3270. Saskatoon Search and Rescue. Stars Ambulance Service. Saskatchewan Air Ambulance. MD Ambulance. St. John's Ambulance. Canadian Blood Services. Military Institute of Saskatoon. Military Family Resource Center. Veterans Village and Sherbrooke Community Center. Army Cadet League of Canada. Canadian War Brides and Family. Canada Remembers Our Heroes Air Show. Canadian Legion of Riders, Bridge City. Groningen, 3rd Cavalry Motorcycle Unit. MLA Paul Merriman, Sutherland. MLA Ken Shibaldayoff, Silver Springs. MLA Gordon Wyant, Saskatoon Northwest. MLA Cam Broughton, Saskatoon Massey Place. MLA David Forbes, Saskatoon Center. MLA Rob Norris, Saskatoon Greystone. MLA Corey Tucker, Saskatoon Eastview. MLA Jennifer Campbell, Saskatoon Fairview. MLA Don Morgan, Saskatoon Southeast. SaskTel Center. Board of Governors, University of Saskatchewan. Saskatoon Chamber of Commerce. Saskatoon Regional Health Authority. Riversdale Business Improvement District. Downtown Business Improvement District. Greater Saskatoon Catholic Schools. Saskatoon Public Schools Board of Education. Congregation Agudas Israel. B'nai B'rith. Congregation Shir Kadash. Adamia Muslim Jamay at Community. 100 members of the community are seated in our stands today. Our Lady of Grace Catholic Women's League. Roman Catholic Diocese of Saskatoon. Ukrainian Catholic Brotherhood of Canada, Bishop Roborecki, Branch 304. Ukrainian Orthodox Church of All Saints. Ukrainian Canadian Congress, Saskatoon Branch. Holy Trinity Ukrainian Orthodox Church. Ukrainian Women's Association of Canada. Ola Hagabashin Branch. St. John's Cathedral Anglican Church Women. Ancient Roaring and Raucous Order of Armisticians. Grand Lodge of Saskatchewan, Ancient Free and Accepted Masons, District Number 5. Knights of Columbus Chapter. Knights of Columbus, Darcy McGee Assembly. Job's Daughters. Saskatoon Shrine Club Number 2 and Masonic Temple Number 1. Order of the Eastern Star, Regal Number 132. Order of the Eastern Star, Chapter 4. Kinsmen Clubs of Saskatoon. Saskatoon K40 Club. Riverside Optimist Club. Hub City Optimist Club. Lions Clubs of Saskatoon. Rotary Clubs of Saskatoon. Saskatoon Optimist Club. The Salvation Army. Saskatoon Kiwanis Clubs. Saskatoon Elks Lodge, number 12. Saskatoon Royal Purple, number 46. As we celebrate the 70th anniversary of the liberation of the Netherlands, a wreath is being placed by the Netherlands Canada Society. Sons of Norway. Seroptimist International, Saskatoon. The Western Development Museum. Canadian Paraplegic Association of Saskatchewan. Ukrainian Self-Reliance Association. Beta Sigma Phi. Cosmopolitan Couples Club of Saskatoon. The Canadian Federation of University Women, Saskatchewan Branch. The Lung Association of Saskatchewan. Girl Guides of Saskatoon. Saskatoon Amateur Radio Club. The International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local Number 529. Canadian Union of Postal Workers. CP Rail Employees, Local Number 793. Amalgamated Transit Union, local number 615. QP number 59. QP number 1975. SGEU local 1102. SEIU West. National Association of Federal Retirees, Saskatoon Branch. Public Service Alliance of Canada. UA Local 179 Plumbers and Pipe Fitters. Saskatchewan Union of Nurses. Health Sciences Association of Saskatchewan. Saskatchewan Polytechnic Facility Association. Saskatchewan Medical Association. Superannuated Teachers of Saskatchewan. A wreath being laid now on behalf of Al Mahoney and his father Joseph. Memorial wreath now being laid on behalf of the Wyant family. In memory of Sergeant Leo Gepperdy. In memory of Leo Rabashinsky. Wreath being laid now from Park Funeral Chapel. Hillcrest Funeral Home. Acadia McCaig Funeral Home. Saskatoon Funeral Home. Persephone Theater. Expert Hearing and Wall Street Audiology. St. Paul's Hospital. Preston Parle Retirement Residence. Dean, the College of Nursing. University of Saskatchewan Students Union. College of Veterinary Students Association. University of Saskatchewan Alumni. Associated Engineering. In memory of Hong Kong prisoners of war. Agricultural Students Association. University of Saskatchewan Faculty Association. University of Saskatchewan Non-Academic Retirees Association. On behalf of the Dean of the College of Dentistry, on behalf of the Dean of the College of Education, on behalf of the Dean of the College of Kinesiology, Market Mall, Saskatchewan Polytechnic, Number 38 Medical Cadet Corps, Number 702, Cadet Squadron. Scouts Canada. Also wreaths being laid by 107 Spitfire Squadron Air Cadets. Number 2293, North Saskatchewan Cadet Corps. Jarvis Bay Sea Cadets. Jarvis Bay, Navy League Cadet Corps, H.M. Weir. Ladies and gentlemen, the Veterans and Legion members would like to show their appreciation for student involvements as they did their services in their schools this week, distributed poppies, and also attended this service. They thank them for honoring the Veterans and Legion members and all Canadians. There's another anniversary of note. This is the 20th year that the services are held here at Sastel Center. And 20 years ago, we became the first indoor largest service in Canada, and today is no exception as we have set a new record, 9,640, to continue to be Canada's largest indoor service.
That the service began here at Sastel Center. During that time, it was a Sask place. In the Sastel Center management, under at that time, Brian Swidrovich took hold of this, and as their cooperation and their brotherhood and sisterhood with the various military organizations has grown so much over the years. And of course, all culminating in the various Canada Remembers air shows that Brian Swidrovich has been very key in organizing.
Thank you.
now invite those who are able to stand for the singing of our hymn, O God, our help in ages past. To come to the microphone.
As we prepare to leave this place that we've marked in remembrance and in prayer, we say, let us go. Go with open hearts that are turned towards peace and harmony. Today, tomorrow, and always.
I ask those who are able to stay standing, and those, and everybody, please join in the singing of God Save the Queen.
Service is now being given over to the military once again.
For the march past.
Reverend Colin Clay is turning the parade over to Parade Commander Lieutenant Colonel Gwen Bork. And we will see the various cadets, the new guard, the old guard, the service organizations march off. But they will also be marching past and giving salute today to Her Honor Vaughan, the Solomon Schofield Lieutenant Governor of Saskatchewan, and to representatives of the Royal Canadian Legion. Representatives of the Royal Canadian Legion who will be receiving compliments today as various members of the Cadet Corps and the Old Guard, the New Guard, and service organizations march past will be the representatives of the Royal Canadian Legion. Shirley Ashton representing Legion Branch number 63, Marguerite Wolfe, Branch number 78, Rose Ferguson, Branch number 362, the Nutana Branch. Wayne Bourget, Alf Christensen, and Jim Eaton, all representing Branch 38. Then Ruth Bond Martinson, who represents the Maple Leaf Unit, which is the only women's veterans organization in Canada.
March.
And being led off by the North Saskatchewan Regiment's Pipes and Drums. This is the march past. Past Lieutenant Governor Vaughn Solomon Schofield. As always, the colors first, then the North Saskatchewan Regiment Pipes and Drums, followed by the flag party. And then, behind that flag party in the center of your screen right now, will be the Old Guard. And the officers of each unit saluting as they march past Lieutenant Governor Vaughn Solomon Schofield and the representatives of the Royal Canadian Legion. Lieutenant Governor Vaughn Solomon Schofield is a strong supporter of the Canadian Armed Forces. She is the provincial chair of the Canadian Forces Liaison Council. She is also the honorary colonel of 38th Service Battalion, which led today's Remembrance Day ceremony. In acknowledgement of her many contributions to the Canadian Armed Forces, Lieutenant Governor Vaughn Solomon Schofield was awarded the prestigious Canadian Forces Medallion for Distinguished Service. She was, of course, sworn in as Saskatchewan's 21st Lieutenant Governor back in the March of 2012. So the Old Guard has been let off.
New Guard will advance in column of route. Mighty right, right, turn.
Jarvis Bay Sea Cadet Band will now march off the New Guard.
All right, the New Guard is now being led off, led by the Jarvis Bay Sea Cadet Band.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first serving Canadian Forces units.
During the laying of the wreaths, we did hear mention of the Boy Scouts of Canada, but we want to give them special mention today. Unfortunately, due to the amount of room that is available on the surface, they were unable to be out in the parade, but they were here and they were well represented. We also would like to give a special thanks to RBC, Royal Bank in Saskatoon, sponsoring free transit service to and from the Remembrance Day ceremony here in Saskatoon today. As the parade is being led off, the New Guard right now being led off, I'd like to tell you about a very special program that will be airing. Anthony Testego has produced and directed a number of documentaries about war veterans. Many of them Canada Remembers documentaries, which have been aired in past years. For the last 5 years, Tony Testego has been producing and directing a documentary called Covers the Earth Boy. And it is his latest war documentary. It's the story of World War II veteran, artist, Henry Boudre, who was a prisoner of war in World War II. And this documentary is going to be airing just a few days, November 15th at 6:30 p.m. on CTV. So 5 years in the making for that documentary from Tony Sestego.
Saskatoon Fire Department.
As announcer Steve Shannon continues to recognize those who are marching past, Lieutenant Governor and the representatives of the Royal Canadian Legion, the crowd continues to stand and applaud. Now, once again, it's heartwarming to see how many of today's youth are here participating in the Saskatoon Remembrance Day service.
107 Spitfire Royal Canadian Air Cadets. 702 Lakes Royal Canadian Air Cadet Squadron.
702 and District Freemasons. Saskatoon Shriners. And Knights of Columbus. Number 45, Jarvis Bay Royal Canadian Sea Cadet Corps. Number 2293, Royal Canadian Army Cadet Corps. Number 328, Royal Canadian Army Medical Cadet Corps. Junior Canadian Rangers. And the Navy League.
Raucous applause for all of the
ladies and gentlemen, sincere appreciation go to my colleague and good friend from Shaw, David Curtin, for carrying this broadcast live over Shaw. Also coming up, a very special war documentary by Anthony Testego
turning up covers the South Health
Center
today.
The last
today
war documentary and the latest
for this
one
Remembrance
about
Day
a story
ceremony.
Of a POW in World War II.
The tradition goes now that following the ceremony, we won't be staying with it, but if you ever do get an opportunity to come down to Saskatoon Center, you do want to stay past the ceremony. The North Saskatchewan Regiment Pipes and Drums will get into the middle of the space here, and they will be performing for the crowd, and it is really quite the show. Our big thanks once again, though, to our musical providers. Music coordinator Peter England, the Salvation Army Band with guests from the Bridge City Brass Band, the Saskatoon Brass Band, all led by Deanna Sawatsky, the Saskatoon Community Wind Ensemble, Peter England, the director, and the Saskatoon Men's Chorus, Lynn Dreger and Deborah Buck, the directors. We thank them, we thank the organizers, and we thank you for tuning in. You have been watching the 84th anniversary of Saskatoon's Remembrance Day
stand
service from Sastel Center in
Please
Saskatoon.
Stand. Shoulder arm. Senate South Guard will reform in single file. Quick mark. my left. Quick march. Just wheel left or out, people.